Hi guys. How's everybody? Everyone's able to see me? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So good evening. Us wait for a couple of minutes, let people join, and I'm just waiting for people to join. Yes, okay, good, exactly, great. So good evening. Continuing with where we discussed it till yesterday. See, ab tak ki kahani or the story till now. See, what we discussed so far is the battles of Panipat. Right? One, two, then three. In the first battle, we see establishment of Mughals. The second battle, we see the coming back of Mughals 2.0. And in the third battle, we see the end of Marathas. Mughals 1.0, Mughals 2.0, and the end of Marathas. Okay. So good evening. So I'm pretty sure everyone's able to see me, everyone's able to understand what I'm saying. This is actually the war series. By the way, I forgot to tell, my name is Ranganathan Iswaran. On An Academy, you can just subscribe to my channel on An Academy as well. Anacademy.com/@SriVanar. Those who are subscribing to An Academy Plus, do use the subscription code SriVanar. Having said that, now this is the time to see the Bengal conflicts. See, between 1600 to 1700, British have been able to establish themselves as a formidable power. Actually, formidable political power. British were able to establish themselves as formidable political power. See, the Mughals were on a decline. The British, yes, just now started, were in a path of growth. They were adding new territories. They were expanding trade and they were expanding their revenue. Jabki Mughals were going through disintegration. नहीं थोड़ा किच किच कर रहा है बस और ब्रिटिश वर गोइंग थ्रू डिसइंटीग्रेशन दैट इज अ डिक्लाइन. How decline? Hyderabad, Murshidabad, or what we call Bengal, Awadh. Like this, many states were developing. Guys, is the voice doing echo? नहीं है ना? नहीं ना? सेफ फॉर नाउ, जस्ट एडजस्ट, आई कांट डू मच. आई मीन ये अभी इफेक्ट स्टार्ट चेंजिंग द सेटिंग्स अभी तो मुश्किल कर जाएगा. नाउ ब्रिटिश टुक टू वॉर्स टू एक्चुअली कॉन्क्वेस्ट और ऑक्यूपाई बंगाल. इट टुक टू वॉर्स फॉर ब्रिटिश टू टेक ओवर बंगाल. दीज वॉर बैटल ऑफ प्लासी एंड बैटल ऑफ बक्सर. प्लासी वॉज फ्रॉम 1757, बक्सर वॉज फ्रॉम 1764. East India Company came to India in 1608, and they will come into becoming a political power in 1757. Now we have to see how they became the political power in 1757. It was primarily through a battle called the Battle of Plassey, 23rd of June, 1757. British came to power under Robert Clive. Whereas the loser in this battle was Nawab Siraj ud Dawla, actually West ud Dawla. I generally call him Bekar ud Dawla. Battle of Buxar was fought slightly little later. It was in a way a continuation of the Battle of Plassey's event. Hector Munro was there, and we had Nawab Mir Qasim, Shah Alam II, and Shuja ud Dawla. Now, for your purposes, remember, Battle of Plassey is one of the most important battles where British even realize that they can actually become a political power. Nawab Siraj ud Dawla, Mr. Muchad, I mean, I generally call him Mr. Muchad, the man with a big mustache. He was one of the greatest Nawabs of Bengal. Now we have to see the background of this. See, Mughals had been some of the greatest powers in India. As a territorial ruler, they've been exactly greatest powers. Raj Babbar or Babur ruled from 1526 to 1530. Humayun, he was like bad luck ka badsha, ruled from 1530 to 1540, 1555-56. Akbar, the boss, 1556 to 1605. Presently KP Oli, previously Jahangir. 1605 to 1628. Some books will say 1627. Okay. During this period, this place is what I call the Langur land. There used to be a country called Langur land. In normal English, they call it Britain. The inhabitants of this land were Gore Langur. Basically, British. Okay. So, they established a company commonly called East India Company or normally called Pradhan Mantri Hindustan Luto Yojana. It was the trading company which was supposed to come to India, loot everything and go back. Okay, so under this Pradhan Mantri Luta Yojana, presently Boris Johnson, previously Thomas Rowe, he gave some gifts to Jahangir, and Jahangir gave a lot of benefits to the British. And what are the benefits? One fellow doing Jingalala dance. iPhone, radio, He wanted all the luxuries of life. Jahangir. East India Company, that is how got permission to trade in Gujarat in Surat in 1618. Within a short period, company was able to establish herself as one of the strongest trading centers with nearly 23 factories by 1647. Then, after Jahangir came Shah Jahan. He was a great architect who knew everything. And then we had, presently we call him Joe Biden, but in the previous birth he was Aurangzeb. Who knows how to mess around things. Okay. Aurangzeb. When British came to India, just next to Langur land is another called Monkey Land, or generally France. Yes, Thomas Rowe gifted some paintings to Jahangir. Not just paintings, but also a few things. There were a few things which were actually gifted. It was not just the paintings. So eventually, during Aurangzeb's period, Murshid Quli Khan splits. And he established a territory called Bengal with its capital Murshidabad. And I'm pretty sure you guys can recognize who presently Murshid Quli Khan is. Derek O'Brien. He's currently Didi's number two. Mamata Banerjee's number two. He's from Bengal. Okay, so Bengal in those days used to be approximately a combination of Bangladesh, Bihar, West Bengal and Odisha. Murshid Quli Khan decided that he will move capital from Dhaka to Murshidabad because he wanted to stay away from any British influence. I mean, the idea of Murshid Quli Khan was he wanted to stay away from any influence of British. This was his way. Then after Aurangzeb came Farooq Bahadur Shah I, Jahandar Shah, the two important twins, twin kings. And then we had the great Farooq Siyar. In the year 1713, it was Farooq Siyar. Farooq Siyar destroyed whatever was left out by Aurangzeb. You guys can recognize who Farooq Siyar is in my slides. In the year 1717, Farooq Siyar gave golden firman to the British, in which Britishers were given total and complete exemption from trading. Total and complete exemption from taxes. Taxes on trading. And at the same time, Murshid Quli Khan was given a promotion. From being the Subedar, he was made the Nawabdar of Bengal. So in a way, he got promotion. Murshid Quli Khan had a son, Shujauddin Muhammad Khan. Murshid Quli Khan's son was Shujauddin Muhammad Khan. Shujauddin's adjutant, or Shujauddin's, you can say, deputy or assistant, is Aliwardi Khan. In the year 1727 to 1739, Murshid Kuli Khan's descendant Shujauddin was ruling Bengal. Now this story is happening in Bengal. For some time leave Mughals. This is all happening in Bengal. Bengal once became Nawabship. The Bengal Nawabs have greater authority now. And Aliwardi Khan in 1728 was made the general. He got promotion in the general of Bengal. And in 1773, he was made the deputy subedar. Bilkul, full promotion. Full on, total complete promotion. In the year 1739, when Shujauddin Muhammad Khan died, he was replaced by Sarfaraz Khan, his son. Shujauddin Muhammad Khan's son, Sarfaraz Khan. Now, you guys tell me, is Aliwardi Khan from the royal family or is he even eligible to become the king? Is Aliwardi Khan from royal family or is he even eligible to become the king? No, right? No. So what Aliwardi Khan did, he killed Sarfaraz Khan and occupied the throne. In the year 1739, Aliwardi Khan killed Sarfaraz Khan and occupied the throne. Aliwardi Khan's next descendant, Aliwardi Khan remained the Nawab of Bengal till 1756 by removing Murshid's family. And his descendant was Sirajuddaula. Nawab Sirajuddaula. That is how Sirajuddaula came to power. Now I am repeating the story. Murshid Kuli Khan. Murshid ke baad Shujauddin Muhammad Khan. Then Sarfaraz Khan. Sarfaraz Khan killed by his general Aliwardi Khan. Then in 1756, he was replaced by Sirajuddaula. Now coming to Siraj. See, the problem with Siraj was Siraj was way too excited. He was like that first year student who has got admission in the best engineering college. Bekar ka excitement. Anger, excitement. He thinks he is like superstar, humne sab kuch kar liya, aham brahmasmi type. And that is where the entire problem with Sirajuddaula comes. He doesn't have patience or diplomacy. Sirajuddaula doesn't have any patience or diplomacy. Now, during this period, one thing I wanted to give you guys as a background is, remember I told you Farrukh Siyar appointed Murshid Kuli Khan as the Diwan or as the Diwan of Bengal as Subedar. Later he became Nawab. During this period, Farrukh Siyar had given a golden firman to English where the East India Company could do trade in Bengal without paying any taxes. Now the problem was this tax-free permit is called Dastak. This Dastak was only for the company trade, not for private. And these people, the company employees, started to use Dastak for their private trade. Now, I'll tell you what is the problem with the private trade and the general trade. See, private trade is where the company employers do trade using company ships, but it is not actually company goods. They are sending private goods. Sirajuddaula was supposed to respect, and even Farrukh Siyar had given tax-free permit only for the company goods, not for private goods, because there is no limit to how many private employees will send, no. How do you know how much they will send? They may send 1, 2, 10, 20, 100, 200, 1000, 10,000. Kitna bechenge? And if sirf Nizam give, the Nawab gives tax-free permits, then the tax-free will become unlimited. There will be no limit to how much they will send. And that's exactly what happened. The company employees started misusing the dastak for their private personal purposes. Now, this would mean the Nawab's traders losing themselves. Right? Nawab's traders are losing their competitive advantage because while English traders are doing tax-free trade, Nawab traders have to pay taxes. नवाब के खुद के आदमी दे हैव टू पे टैक्सेस नो दैट इज व्हाट हैपेंड फ्रॉम 1739 अलीवर्दी खान वांटेड टू मेंटेन वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट कंट्रोल ऑन दिस व्हेन ही ओवरथ्रो मुर्शिद कुली खान्स फैमिली अलीवर्दी खान नेवर लाइक्ड दिस दस्तक वाला कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर हिम दस्तक वाज नॉट राइट्स Now, and remember, what is dastak is? Dastak is tax-free permits. Given to traders of East India Company. Dastak is essentially tax-free permits given to the traders of East India Company. In this situation is where the Battle of Plassey started. So already Bengal Nawab has dispute or kind of unhappiness with the British. When Siraj-ud-Daulah came to power, he just lost control. I mean, he just became extremely angry. Now, my question is, Siraj ud-Daulah really eligible to become the king directly? I mean, is he eligible actually? No, right? Even if Siraj has killed, I mean, Aliwardi Khan, Siraj's ancestor, killed Sarfaraz Khan, don't you think Sarfaraz's family have a legal claim on the throne? Sarfaraz's family will always have a legal claim on the throne. Isn't it natural to happen? That is what happened. British started to entertain this. See, British understood they could play the game. Shaukat Jung, the Fauzdar of Purnia, and Ghaseedi Begum, Aliwardi's daughter, even Aliwardi's daughter, she was challenging Siraj coming to power. Whereas another group was Jagat Seth, Umi Chand, Raj Ballabh, Rai Durlabh, and Mir Jafar. These people opposed Aliwardi and Siraj's family. They wanted Murshid's family to come back. So even the Bengal Nawab was broken into different factions. A group supporting Siraj, two groups opposing Siraj. There was factional revolution. English were supporting Krishna Das. Ghaseedi Begum was being opposed by English. It was a kind of chaotic situation. So there was a sense of insecurity between British, sorry, it is Bengal Nawab So the Bengal Nawab Shib had a sense of insecurity among herself. ऐसे सिचुएशन में कंपनी ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड बिल्डिंग फोर्ट्स. नाउ द रीजन वाई कंपनी वॉज बिल्डिंग फोर्ट्स इज इन ए प्लेस कॉल्ड चंदर नागौर. फ्रेंच हैड फोर्ट. सो इन कैलकटा कंपनी वॉज स्ट्रेंथनिंग हर सेल्फ बिकॉज नॉट इन इंडिया बट इन यूरोप there was a 7 year war going on, 1756 to 1763. Europe, USA regions, the British and French were actually fighting with each other. Now, see, they are building fort in Siraj's territory, no? Don't you think it is legal for Siraj to oppose this fortification? Don't you think it is legal? And Siraj has every right to oppose this. Even if they want to do fortification, don't you think they should have asked Siraj permissions first? They should have asked first, no? They did not ask any permissions. That is where Siraj got very angry. Siraj Udala said no. Already Siraj doesn't like the British because they don't pay taxes. Now they are doing fortifications. Siraj did not like this. Siraj immediately ordered the British to stop their fortifications since they did not take any permissions from the Nawab. British did not agree. While French agreed, the French East India Company said, okay, okay, fine. The British were like, nahi karni, nahi karenge, not interested. While French agreed, British did not. They opposed it. Because remember, Britishers were actually supporting those people who challenged Siraj ud Daula in power. Agree? So in this situation, a dispute began. Nawab Siraj ud Daula, who was infuriated with British, went with a 3,000 strong army to Calcutta. And he attacked. Hashtag British attack. Siraj ud Daula attacked Fort Williams. In Fort Williams, a few Britishers were captured. They were all put in a hole, a little room. 142 Englishmen were actually captured, it seems, in a small room meant only for about 80 people. 80 logon ke room mein around 143 people were put. Only 23 survived. Now you can understand. This event is called Black Hole Incident. This event was picturized in English newspapers as barbarism, radicalism. Siraj the villain. It was projected as if things were pretty bad. Siraj ud Daula is a Dracula, is a very evil man type logic. Naturally, you can expect the people's reaction. Don't you think company would want to come and attack? And say, Siraj himself, did he have intention to kill? No. Siraj only wanted to protest. He was very angry that these guys were unwantedly doing fortification without any permissions. This was strictly an instance of Siraj actually getting angry because Britishers were doing fortifications without taking permission. They were disrespecting his office. Agreed? That was the only reason. No, in this, Yashwan, French support was not even required. Siraj came all by himself. This was French were not involved. Calcutta fell. Even other territories of English in Calcutta fell. When the news reached England, when the news reached Madras, Clive was very angry. The British got extremely angry. This event is called the Black Hole Tragedy. It was actually a guy called Zephaniah Hallwell who escaped. There's a guy called John Zephaniah Hallwell. You see this man. I show one second. Huh. There's a guy called John Zephaniah Hallwell. Later in Calcutta, we used to have Hallwell Monument. Again, you will hear about Hallwell Monument when you are reading about Subhash Chandra Bose. After quitting Congress, the first monument where Subhash Chandra Bose attacked was the Hallwell Monument in Calcutta. Calcutta was renamed as Ali Nagar. Hallwell and others protested. They raised an issue. And the way this entire incident was projected is an evil Siraj attacked peaceful Britishers. When Siraj Uddaula himself got to know this, he was not very happy. Meanwhile, Robert Clive from Madras took his forces and came to Calcutta. Clive with 3,000 soldiers, well-trained soldiers, came to Calcutta. Seeing British coming to march, Siraj and British did a peace agreement called the Ali Nagar Peace Treaty. Now, the reason why Ali Nagar Peace Treaty was done, this was done between Siraj and British, because Siraj knew that although he did not intend to, but people died. So it was kind of Siraj's guilt, which he made him understand, okay, something is wrong. And also Siraj probably wanted to avoid a war because he had his own internal conflicts now. Siraj had his own internal conflicts also to challenge, right? Saltanat. दिमाग होता तो नवाब क्यों बनते, राजा बनते. बेसिकली नवाब मीन्स लेजी लेथार्जिक फेलो. अलीनगर पीस ट्रीटी. अंडर द अलीनगर पीस ट्रीटी, फोर्ट विलियम्स वॉज मेड ब्रिटिश प्रॉपर्टी. ब्रिटिश वर अलाउड टू मिंट देयर ओन कॉइन्स. Britishers do not have to pay any taxes to the Nawab, and Britishers were even allowed to keep their own army. So, would you agree that this step of signing Alinagar Peace Treaty is a retrograde step? Siraj, in spite of winning the war, was actually coming back. And this treaty would have boosted the confidence of British. In fact, Robert Clive, who came, even arranged in a way that Mir Jafar, one of the biggest opponent of Siraj Uddaula, was made the Mir Bakshi, commander in chief. Manikchand was made the officer in charge. Amir Chand, the rich merchant, was kept in Siraj's court. Jagat said one of the biggest bankers was Siraj's banker now, and Khadim Khan commanded the largest of the Nawab's troops. Now, all these guys in red, these are all anti-Siraj group. And as part of the Alinagar Treaty, they were made to join Siraj's court. This was one of the biggest blunders. And that is how Mir Jafar comes to power. The greatest cheater of India. Mir Jafar. We will see Mir Jafar's story and how Mir Jafar comes into power in tomorrow's class. See you guys. All right. Tomorrow, 10 p.m., we will meet Mir Jafar. Thank you. Bye-bye.